Hi, I'm making this video about energies and when we ask other people to send us healing or send us energy. Of course, people who have worked hard to raise their own energy levels are asked all the time, can you send energy for this? Can you send energy to this person? I want to talk about three things that we can keep in our awareness either while asking for energies from somebody else or sending energies to somebody else. The first aspect is that to send energy to someone, the person has to raise their energies, pull energies from the universe, and send it to the person who's asking to receive this energy. It could be somebody who's not well, it could be somebody who's going through a bad emotional phase, it could be somebody who's feeling very, very sad. But if we are asking someone to send energy and that person's energy personally is also going in sending the universal energy through him, then there has to be a fair exchange of energy for the energy that the person is also expending, the time that is taken. The second aspect is that, are you sure that you are asking the right people for energy? Sometimes we don't even know people and who they are, and we just end up asking for energy because everyone else is speaking very highly of them. Is their energy aligned with your energy? Do you really want energy from them? Think and then ask. See the profile of the person you are asking for. If it matches with your energetic sense, then ask. The third thing is that when you are asking for energy, please know how will the person send. So for example, if you are saying please send energy, the other person should tell you that I'm sending you energy between this time and this time. So please ask the patient, or if it is for yourself, that please be open, put an intention, please be open at this time, receive my energy. And the person who has asked for energy should give some kind of a feedback to the person who has given energy to say, this is how I felt and this is how it is. Thank you very much. There has to be a gratitude and there has to be an understanding that what will it entail. Sometimes when people ask for energy, they think that after that half an hour of energy session, their problems will end. Or if they were in a very horrible mood, they will suddenly feel like dancing again. Energy is very subtle. It is not going to shift you completely without your being present to making changes to your own situation. So for example, if I'm feeling very depressed about something and I've had a fight with someone and I'm asking someone to send energies, at that time, while he's sending energies, I'm still processing the fight in my mind. Why did he say this? Why did she say this? He could have said it a little better. That energy will affect me at a very subtle level. After that half an hour, my mood will not change. So when you are receiving energy from someone, or you are asking for energy for your child or a sick person, ask them, what is it that they can shift in this half an hour? Can they chant something peaceful? Can they be at peace? Can they go into a moment of joy that they had in the past? Because then the energy works very fast. So please send me energies is one of the most common things that people do without realizing the subtleties of energy. The other thing that we always have to keep in mind is that, are you in faith, first of all? Just because someone is there and they can give energy doesn't mean, and everyone is saying, please send me energy, you are also saying, please send me energy. Energy for what? Have you described your situation to that person? Have you explained how you have tried to work on it, but you haven't been able to? Is it for a health issue? Is it for a mental issue? Is it for an emotional issue? So always understand that energies are very subtle. Energies work at a very subtle level, but they only work when you work. So it is always a two-way process. And if you don't have faith, please do not ask, because if you don't have faith, you're really looking already for the loopholes in the system. And there are a lot of people who say distance energy doesn't work. It does work. I don't have to be physically present. Of course, touch energy is very different, but I don't have to be physically present for people who need this from me. Yeah? And nor does any other healer. So if you don't have faith, please do not do energy work and don't be in a circle that asks for energy, because without faith, energy does not move. Remember that with faith, a stone is also God. You go and worship it in the temple. But without faith, even God is just a statue. So the difference in your life comes from faith. I thought this was an interesting topic because a lot of people keep asking me to send energies. I think it is important for all of us to know what it really entails when we ask for this. I hope it has helped you in understanding. And if it has, please comment on our YouTube channel. And if you have any topics that you would like me to make short videos on, do let me know. Thank you.